Because I had patients who were really compromised because of the demonic. And I found even in the hospitals that if we didn't get rid of that, it was really going to be hard to get people well the way that they wanted to. I have many, many cases, examples of this. One of my favorites was a fellow that I prayed for who was in a kind of a comatose condition, and that he wasn't, you know, real clear or verbal or anything. But the demonic was very strong in him, and this was one man who, like some of the people I cared for, was very violent. And he tried to punch me and bite me and kick me and would lunge at me from his hospital bed. He actually had to tie his arms down, and he was impossible. I'd go in there and, you know, there he'd be like, fly at me to, like, you know, hurt me. So I prayed over this man, and the devil left, the demonic left him, and he was freed. And then he became like a different person. All of a sudden, he could get healed very beautifully from God, very nicely. He was one of my super overweight patients in the hospital, and in a couple weeks, he had dropped over 100 pounds. Now, that is not something we normally see in the medical field. I've seen up to 200-pound weight losses really fast from God. But the man, his behavior changed, he lost all this weight, all of his medical issues cleared up so quickly, and the nurses all said this is a complete miracle. They said this man's had a miracle healing. And it was very sweet. Before they discharged him, he was crying and sobbing and so grateful for the healing and the kindness and everything. He really choked him up. And so we don't want the enemy in anybody.